Okay. So, we're going to do replay analysis. Let's start from the beginning. What is it? Why? I believe we lost this match. But it was pretty close. It was 3-2. We were doing pretty solid, but there's definitely a couple of plays we could have improved on. So, it's me, Joe, and Will. Let's start it. So, standard kickoff. This is just fine. Hit it over there. I collect boost. Will moves up. Let's see. Yeah, that's fine. The only thing right here. Actually, no. Joe was moving up. I think that was pretty solid. Good awareness. So, Will goes to play the ball. I'm falling back for boost and to protect the net. And then Joe instantly moves up to get the miss or the rebound that Will sets up. A solid play. I'm there for the defense. And let's see what we do here. Okay, yeah. That could be better. So it comes, I hit to the side. We have Joe coming back. Joe should be the one getting net since he is the farthest away. We do have time since I'm hitting away, and the only person that can get it back is this Kenway thing. It's kind of hard to have this level of awareness, but it works. I think I screwed up into a sideways flip instead of actually doing a double jump. Right here, I think, yeah, Will probably should have moved up quicker. So that he could have got the aerial. Instead of rotating all the way back to net, do a little quicker turnaround, knowing that Joe is going to be back there, because he was really quick. Yeah, they get there just about the same time. No reason to have two people back in net like this. But that's kind of hard to do with, you know, that kind of situational awareness. I need to talk to someone. Okay, let's see this again. So, looks like I rotate to boost. Joe has net, and Will goes up. He goes for the miss, but that's fine. And then I rotate net, and then Joe hits it away. Either me or Will. So as soon as Will goes in, I should be moving out. Yep, it's perfect. What happened over here on the challenge? Joe goes for the wall. He got stuffed. And then, this is a good rotation here. See that? Goes for the stuff. I move up. It's over my head. I rotate net, and then Will takes it away. Immediately, it looks like I'm following up the ball. And Joe is following behind. This is really good. I really like seeing all three of us moving up like this when we have a good clear. Yeah, that was totally my mistake right there. So, we have a solid clear. Will moves up, and I should go straight center to try to keep that in. I don't know why I take this really wide angle. And then it's just me and Joe hiding in the back here, so neither one of us are useful. Joe's in the right position. I was taking center, and it looks like I just didn't follow up for some reason. At this scenario, Joe goes back to get boost, and I try to keep it in. That looked a little weird. What happened here? Okay. I see. Yeah, that was another mistake by me. So, I saw Will get the boost. I get stuff, and I need to rotate back. At this point, Joe should be moving up to take my position, and I need to rotate back to get boost. Okay, no. Everyone did good. Right here, someone needs to be center. Yeah, so Joe knows that I'm, or at least we should have communicated, or he should be aware that I am heading back. You should be able to see me right here. And taking the defensive position. At this point, I think he should be moving straight to mid for a setup. So instead, takes half field, a little bit back below half. Will fights corner. And no one's there fast enough to really make good on that. I think if Joe moves straight up here, and then I took the back position instead of going for the challenge since he was closer, that might have been converted into a point. Hard to tell, but at least we'll have had a better shot. And Joe keeps it in nice. So at this point, Joe knocks it in. Yeah, it's awkward, goes over his head, and immediately rotates back. That's great. And I don't know what I'm doing here. I see that Joe's rotating back. I should take that boost and then go center for the pass that Will's making right here. Instead, I do this really long rotation back. And then I'm just trying to keep it in at this point. That could have been a shot chance. And instead, it didn't work out very well. And Joe with a really nice shot playing garbage man. But yeah, that would have been way better if I was up there faster. Instead, I kind of screwed around. Okay. Another thing right here I just noticed. Joe keeps it in. And Will goes all the way back for far boost. Probably could have taken mid boost instead of doing a full rotation. And then been able to challenge this clear right here. Keep it in. Especially with Joe moving back as well. We now have... It's on their half of the court. And we have two people in the back half. I think we fight this one out. Yeah, we fight this one out. It would have been much easier to keep it in if Will was up a little more. Alright. Interesting. Alright, I think that was really good. Let's highlight everything that happened here. So, it was over Joe's head, and Will had the right idea to fly and keep it in. Joe had the awareness and the trust that his back person was going to keep it in. And it looks like I was aware that I was way too far up and I was rotating back after my failed pass. Ooh. Okay, I should have taken a little... I kind of went center. I should have just rotated straight back. I don't know why I was taking center. That was my bad. I would have had an easier time with this ball here. Okay. So, I'm dribbling this. I'm working this ball up. I have it. There's no reason for this position right here. We are way too close. We're right on top of each other. We just kind of slam into it. And now we have two people out of position. And Joe has to make the really difficult decision. Stay back and defend or try to challenge. Looks like he goes for the challenge. We get lucky that they were also in kind of bad position with this because they also had two people out of position. But if they were a little bit better formed, this could have been trouble. Yeah, so Joe, playing smart, keeping back. Right there. Yeah. So. I move up, keep in, I kind of have a weird hit, and it stops my forward momentum, so I can't really make a challenge. The one thing we are doing wrong here is, it's in their half, they're probably going to get a good clear, but we should at least have one person getting ready to challenge. Instead we have three people moving backwards, all at the same time, and they hit a corner and we have no one there to really challenge it. That looked awkward. I'm not really sure how we should have. Like, okay, so that play happened. We're kind of in a weird position. Looks like I was going for it, but I didn't like his hit. So I rotated back. And then Joe and Will right next to each other. If you guys were just spaced out a little more, then this would have been much better. Instead of... So it looks like Joe was the most forward facing person, so it should have been Will's responsibility to kind of hang back a little bit instead of going for the ball. Now we have two people in the exact same position essentially, It bounces a little farther than we expect because he gets this wall hit. And now both of them have to backtrack in order to make up for this. I don't know what I was doing. Let's take a look at what happened there. I go back, I grab that boost, and I rotate. I was rotating for a challenge, I guess. I don't really like my position either. I kind of worked out, but whatever. I think this is a goal, yeah. Bam. I do like, though, how we turned this around right away. As soon as we saw this forward momentum, all three of us charging for it. And then, boom, I get the shot, was the backup, and then Joe is in the back to contain. This is perfect positioning. And it's a goal. Standard kickoff. Did I get bumped? I was moving way too far up. I think I did. No, I was just an idiot. Yeah, I'm way too far up on this. Looks like Joe is moving back, so it kind of worked, but still. Okay, it's moving to the side. Joe's here. So, if I were to predict what's going to happen is I move up wall, Joe comes up midfield, and then Will should take back from this current position. Let's see what actually goes on. I don't challenge it. I head back. You see, this isn't really good either. Like, this ball is moving across their side. And we have three people. I mean, I'm heading back. I definitely messed up. We're all way back behind the half line. I mean, really, I don't know why I did that. I should have just taken that boost and rotated up. This is totally mine. Oh, there was no boost. It looks like I didn't need it anyways. And then there's another mistake by me. So, but messed that up. So here I should just be going straight net, because I know Will's up ahead, and Joe, I should trust Joe that has it, and I should be taking that. Instead, I kind of get in a strange position. Thankfully, Will has the presence of mind. And yeah, I remember this. So, I don't think this is too bad. I'm kind of practicing wall shots, so kind of a stupid shot to try to take. Will definitely has the better opportunity. But this puts both of us way out of position because we both miss. Woo! And now Joe's stuck with that shitty position again where he knows both of his teammates are up. He has a lot of pressure coming this way. And this guy's already flying for it. There's no way he's going to challenge. Gets into net, and then me and Will are both way out of position coming back because we both went for that ball. But again, I don't think that's too bad. Will definitely was in the better position than me, but practicing wall shots, so. Alright. I just praised Will, but he just fucked up. So, right here. Oh, actually. No, it was Joe. Joe that messed up. Has a good clear. Kind of moves out for it. Right here. If he would have kept moving forward, then his position would have been fine. But since he turned around, he now slowed himself way down. Will has a much better opportunity to go and put pressure on the ball because he has momentum already. And Joe's backwards facing to the ball. I think at this point, Joe should just rotate net and Will should take his place. Which kind of happens. I mean, Will definitely tries to take his place because he almost bumps him. I go for the ball, Joe goes for the ball. And then we're in the... Alright, that was a little weird. Let's see what happened here. Boop. Okay, it looks like we were surprised by that inner bounce. So, I go for the pass, I miss, get thrown into net. Will takes a shot, and... Joe's going for the bump out, but it takes that weird inside bounce, which is always annoying. I see an opportunity to keep it in. I rotate in, and Will goes center for a potential pass right here. Yeah, Will should be getting back. Yeah. So, right here, Will sees it bounces inside. He's out of position to get another touch. And they are really in probably good position to clear. I might be able to knock it in. And I mean, he's just chasing. Will's just chasing the ball at this point, isn't he? Bam, he hits over there. He sees the ball. Oh, I can get the ball. So he chases it. Everyone beats him. Wall goes a different direction. He circles, still chasing it. Bam. Wall goes a different direction again. Still chasing the ball. And misses again. So, really, after, like, right. Right here is at the point where Will and Joe should be switching position. Will should go back, Joe should move up. Joe's in a much better position for hitting a potential pass than Will is at this point. He has full boost, Will has been spending it. Just rotate back. Even there, like he was heading backwards, this would be a great time for Joe to move up and Will move back. But instead he misses that block. I don't like my position here either. So, I hit it over. What do I do? See it. I kind of take the weirdest flip in the world. And I know that Joe should be the one blocking this. Will is out of position. I should be taking back in order to contain the ball and keep it in their end. Instead, I go for the challenge. It's a really hard challenge. And then they get 50-50 ball. It goes cross court, so I have a nice easy clear, but still bad position. Okay. Let's see what's happening here. Yep, I'm moving up. Looks like we all cycled for boosts. Oh yeah, you guys, I remember this. You guys were kind of bumping, got bumped a couple times. That really isn't our fault. Masson was kind of bumping both of you guys. So it was just unfortunate. But you guys instantly get back into a good position. Will moves up. I move. This is a perfect play right here. This is picture perfect. I set up. Will goes for the shot. He doesn't quite make it, but that's fine. I rotate back because I'm out of position. Joe rotates up and gets a nice shot. Will goes for the steal, but whatever. Alright, again. That was a good play too. Good rotation. We all got moved around. It kind of beats us, but they had a really good clear, so that's fine. I actually remember that they score. Yeah. Okay. There is one thing. This is me. I should have been a little bit more to the left to prepare for the inside clear. Kind of screwed up there. And they have a really hard hit here, and I get beat. Will should be challenging. Which he tries, and Joe takes net. I kind of take a really weird angle back. What I should have done is taken the inside angle to, because Will's already going for the challenge. Maybe if he had a better pass, they could have done something, but an inside angle would have been better. And then they score. That one's kind of really tricky of what to do. Really, if this pinch was a little better, it would have been solid, but, I mean, it was almost there. Yeah, if that was a good pinch, they would not have scored that, so. It's kind of unlucky. It's just a mechanical thing, so. Not really too much blame to go around on that one. Okay. I don't like this at all. I remember this one. Actually, no. This is not one. Alright, so what happened here? Goes up for it. Hits it. Yep, I remember this. So, right here. Will is under the ball. Straight under it. Let's reverse this a little bit. Hits up. Will's waiting for the pass. It's a little awkward for him because this guy hits it up. Right here, this ball is almost straight vertical from him. He jumps when the ball is pretty much right above him. That's an extremely hard hit, and if you did hit it, you're going to hit it up and not out. So, even if you did achieve this aerial, it was not good. So, what happens here, Joe goes for it, he hits it, and now you guys are both out of position. If Will would have just stayed back just a little bit, and instead of going for this aerial, had trust that Joe would have got it because he was in better position, boop, he would have been a great setup to get a second hit and really truly clear this. I don't know what I'm doing at this point. I think I'm hiding back. Yeah, just collecting boosts, and I go for another clear. That being said, right afterwards, it looks like we both reacted. We all reacted fairly well. I remember this too. So right here, me and Joe are both in net, deep in net. Probably Joe at this point should move out. I don't know if I communicated to him that was behind him. But either way, he should be moving out for a challenge. Probably like right about here is when he should be moving out. There's no way there's going to be shot on net before I'll be in there. Get out there and get ready for a pass or whatever. Will does the backflip instead of boost, which is whatever. And that goes in with the weird shot. Game side up, we really fall apart after that second goal. I think we're probably on tilt, trying to score again. Alright, let's see that kickoff. Goes up, hits wide. Try to keep it in. Will has no boost right now, so he should be getting back, which he is. Oh, that was funny. So, me and Will are both starved on boost, and we're flipping back. We both hang net, nets panicking, and we keep just wreck each other. One of us should have went boost, one of us should have went net. Especially since we're both boost starved, we not only have one person on the team that has boost, and we have two people in net, and neither one of us can really block an aerial shot, so it's kind of pointless. One of us should have got boost. And then after they get boost, rotate net, and the other person can move out and collect boosts, however. And then again, we both go into net, and then we both come out of net. This is not good. All three of us grouped up together. You know, any knock over, you know, just slightly in our direction is going to beat all three of us. Not good. Me and Will both go for this. That was probably Will's shot, not really mine. I should have, I guess at this point, I might have been assuming that Will was in net. It's hard to say. But either way, I probably, it wasn't the great shot. Should have rotated back, let Will take it. And then Joe was solid position, waiting for the pass to do something with it. And then again, we're still bunched up after that. And now we're hugging each other. So we get a little bit cleared up. Joe takes challenge, I take net. This is pretty solid. Nothing really wrong with that clear. We worked it. I don't know what's happening here, though. Let's see. I think we're just star for boost. Yeah. Looks like. Saw that the enemy was going to get it. Grab boost. Joe was thinking grab boost, go back to net. Will went for the challenge. And then I was way over here for some reason. Why was I over there? Oh, I missed that hit, and then that was on my way to get boosts, and I got bumped. Okay, fair enough. Yeah, so I made a mistake here. I saw that Joe, Will was going to clear it off wall. I should have trusted him that he would have had this clear, and I should have been instantly moving in this direction for the pass and to assist with this clear. Instead, I also go up for the ball and then have a bad landing, and I'm stuck back here. It's a solid clear. Looks like Joe's going inside. I'm taking back. Okay. Another instant of kind of mispositioning. Let's see this explosion. Wow, it's not as good as I thought it was going to be. Anyways. Will shouldn't be here. Will should be more towards center. We now have two people in corner. Even if we did get a good center, no one's going to score that. So, Will should have trust that Joe is going to get a solid pass. He sees that. Maybe he thought Joe got exploded, in which case that would be fine to go center. But either way, Joe's in a better position, and we need someone center just in case he gets the pass. He doesn't. I move up to center. One of these two needs to move back immediately because I'm a little up, but it's an easy center, so It shouldn't be too bad as long as one of us moves back. So, yeah. No one really moved back. Joe couldn't move back because he was flying in the air on the wall. Will probably could have. Let's see. Get it over there. Gets knocked over his head. And now they have an easy clear. I believe I'm in net, and then Will's getting back. So we'll take net, and then Joe should challenge here in this scenario. Joe does that. What? I don't know why that reset like that. That was kind of weird. The fuck? What the heck happened? I don't know what the fuck is. Oh, it's overtime. Okay. Yeah, that's confusing. Overtime! So I go for it. Bam. I remember this. This is not good. I win the face off. It gets knocked over into their far corner where they don't have any people at. What we do, see, Joe's in this corner, Will's over there. It's over in their end, and we got three people back behind half court. I'm moving across, yeah. Will's kind of moving up. We should have had, it just should have been quicker. At the moment we saw this face-off win, Will should be charging up and following that up. I don't know why Joe took net in this scenario. I also think Joe should be moving up. And if anything, I should be the one rotating back since I had to move back and get boost. Instead, I think I take mid. Yeah, I take mid. Alright. Joe's in net. The ball is moving in for a shot. I really think he should be, you know, around half court. You know, playing the normal containment position, right? So, wow, that was so bad by us. So I'm a little far back than normal. I should probably be a little bit more up if I'm truly playing center. But, I mean, Joe is so far back, this is in a terrible position. I challenge it. And I just smack Will's recovery. It was a little over my head, I should have probably just rotated straight back since it was over me. Yeah. See, Will gets boost, rotating net. What happens here? Okay. My Will's mistake here. We know we have no one in net, and we both go for this ball. Yeah, we see Joe go for it and miss that save or clear or whatever. And then both me and Will go for it. Should have been better communication. Either one of us really had a line. I'm just better than Will, that's why I got this. but it gets blocked by Mighty Zeus, and now we have two people out of position. If anything, we both wanted to come out, one of us should be playing a little bit farther back and getting ready for the pass. Instead, we're both in the exact same position, playing the exact same ball. It gets blocked by it, and now we're both too much forward momentum, and we have to rotate back. Luckily, Joe's in net, but it doesn't really matter, because they scored. So yeah, we had to really have a really hard rotation. Put way too much force on Joe. So, I mean, that whole thing. Let's go over time. That whole thing was really started by that kickoff, wasn't it? So, overtime, kickoff, one more time. Hit that. Will needs to be charging up. Joe shouldn't be rotating net. Especially since it has forward momentum and should be trusting that I'm going to rotate back after I get boost. Alright, here. I see there's no one center, so I kind of take center. I should be playing a little farther up and trusting that Joe's going to move up. So, the only person in good position here is really Will. I should be more towards this area of the net. Will's in good position with the pass. It was an okay pass, but, I mean, they were all there. Joe should be like right around this position, a little bit behind half probably. Boom. We'll have had an easy chance of clearing it back. It was kind of unfortunate that we ran into each other. I mean, that's just really bad luck more than anything. Joe goes, misses this. And then again, here, me and Will should not be playing the same ball. Either A, one of us should be staying in net, or B, one of us should stay a little bit behind the other and go for the pass instead of both playing the same ball. So, that's this replay analysis. Yeah, I'm going to upload this now.